Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're located. My name is Petr Dragic, and it's my pleasure to present you the PowerPad, a new on the market software solution for power line design. Before I start with my presentation, I want to mention that this presentation is available with different subtitles in several languages. If you want to turn on subtitle on this presentation, just find settings button, then choose option subtitles /CC and find for which language you wanna to have your subtitle. Okay, the subtitle will be shown on your video. What you will learn from this presentation? This is short agenda, what I will present you directly in solution. You will learn how to design transmission and distribution lines. When I start with demonstrating in solution, first I will present you how you can to create surface. Then I will present you how you can to create your power line. After that, I will show you how you can to exchange data with other software solutions, how you can to customize your data models which you want to use for your projects, and of course I will show you available calculations and reports in this solution, and for the end I will present you B model of overhead power line. And why is that important? Actually, why is it important that digital record of overhead power line? Okay, I also want to answer on question why we created the PowerPad. There are a lot of reasons, but the first one is reason because we want to create solution with understandable workflow and user interface for using solution. That is the reason why we create that in non-CAD environment. Another reason is we want to create solution for which one you don't need to pay for expensive trainings to learn it. With prepared written and video materials, you can learn it in few hours. Third reason is we want to create BIM, building information solution, because the answer is simple. There are no software solutions which supporting BIM approach in designing power lines. Where PowerPad can be applied? PowerPad is solution which can be applied for creating transmission and distribution lines. It means there are no any limitations in designing any type of the power lines for high, medium or low voltage power lines. Also, that is important. PowerPad is not just for creating or designing overhead lines. It is standalone solution with integrated tools for 2D design and for 3D modeling. And it means designers can to create any of the technical drawings with this solution. Let's go now directly in solution for demonstrating the PowerPad features. This is how looks PowerPad interface. When you open solution, first you will get the home page where you have options for starting with new drawing, open drawing, or option for previewing recently used drawings. If you click on help button on left side, solution will give you PowerPad support portal, which is actually knowledge base of the PowerPad solution. Here you can to find well-prepared written and video materials for learning how to use software solution. Let's go on open drawing, and I wanted to find one example which I want to use for creating one power line project. Let's open this one. Before I start with creating one power line, let's make a quick tour of the solution interface. First, on top left side is PowerPad tab which contain or icons for creating power lines. When you move mouse on each icon, you can to see that you have a short description for that icon. On right side, you have different panels. For example, property panels, layout panels, attachment panels, and etc. In any way, user can to modify it or customize panels which want to use. Down, you can to change different profile for drafting modeling, 3D modeling, and etc. If you're going on other tabs, you can to see here that I have icons or comments for 2D drafting because I'm in 2D drafting profile. If I click on Project Explorer, actually first icon on the ribbon, you can to see that is the palette with the main elements of each power line project. Okay, now let's start with creating one power line. But before that, let's to zoom what I have here for my input data. Actually, I opened one just image, that is raster image. And if you're going on properties, I can to find more details about that image. What I need first to do is to create surface. There are a lot of ways for creating surface, but in this example, I will create surface for one external file. Let's to find that file. Actually, that file is the file with the points. I will open it to show you how it looks. Let's first open that file. If I open it, you can to see that I have just points. Actually, X, Y, Z coordinate for each point. Okay. I will now open that file and solution will be automatically create surface from that points. If I'm going to surface, I can to see that I have created surface one. Let's click on surface and go on properties. If I'm going here on properties, I have different options for visibility. For example, if I want to turn on contours, I can do it. Just go and turn on. And you can to see my contours. Of course, you can to change colors of those contours. For example, let's change it for better visibility. Maybe for better visibility, you can also turn off the triangles. Let's go there and turn off triangles. Now I have just contours. For contours, you can to change interval and then also here on property to see the main statistic data of that surface. Let's turn on triangles and turn off contours. Okay. If I'm going on group for creating surfaces, I have different options for editing, assigning image, renaming, importing from different files. Let's go on command assign image because I want to also show one really cool command for dropping image on surface. I will go on assign image on the icon, but let's, for better preview, change it in realistic visual style. Okay, like this. Now I will go on command assign image. And first I need to select thin surface, then raster image. When you start each command in the command line, you can to learn what you need to do. Okay, now you can to see that I have draped image on my surface. And you can to see how it looks in realistic view. If I'm going in default top view, first I need to change visual style and okay, also I want to turn off triangles for better visibility in top view. Let's go on top view. I have created surface. The next step is to create my power line or my root of the power line. you need to define the name of your power line. Next, what you need to define is station, and after that the name of your pole. I will start with the pole 1. For tension support model, I will use one of the already created or existing models from library of the power pad. For weather and referent conditions, I will use the pole to weather and referent conditions. I want to drape my power line on the existing surface with the name surface 1. Now I need to define the position of my tension poles. Like you can to see, it is very simple to define the position of tension poles. Also, you have preview or preview of the distance between the previous and next poles. Let's add, for example, one more tension pole. Now I have created my alignment with, I think, 6 poles, and if I zoom it, I can to see the position of each pole. Of course, if you want to edit it, you need just to select and move on new position. Let's maybe change position and the last one of the pole on this alignment. Okay. And let's say this is my alignment of overhead line. Of course, I have option for zooming each of the poles. Just imagine to have hundreds or thousands of the poles and to want to edit some of the pole. If I'm going on view and 3D view, this is what I want to present you. This is one of the big advantage of the power pad, because once you have created your alignment, you have immediately it in 3D. What it means? It means that you can to see that 3D models of your tension poles. Let's go on top view to show you another functionalities for editing power line. There also a function for edit power line, remove power line. You can also run that command from Project Explorer if you're going to right click. Let's go now supports. For example, if I want to add more supports on the power line, I need to run command add support, and then I need to define which type of support I want to add. In this example, first I want to add a few suspension supports, for example, here and here. And of course, I can to continue my alignment with tension supports. Let's add 2 more tension supports. Okay, when I want to finish, just I need to press on OK. On the list in Project Explorer, I have now added supports. Also, I can to move supports. Actually, I can to move tension supports on this way. If I want to click on alignment and just move tension supports. But also I have another functionalities for editing supports. For example, if I want to edit support with more parameters, I can to go on command edit support. And for example, I can to change data model. I can to change X, Y position of the support. Also, I have an option for remove or rotate support. For moving suspension support, I need to go on command move support, and then you need just to select which suspension support you want to move. Okay, let's move on new position. In next step, I want to go farther and to add insulator on my power line. I will click on command add insulator, and then I need to select support or poles where I want to add my insulator. When I select pole, solution show me where are already attachment points on that poles and which insulator and data model I want to add. I want here apply to add on all tension supports this one insulator. And if you zoom on insulator, you can to see how it looks. Also, if we zoom on another tension poles, you can too see that insulator. Also, is one command for adding insulators on all, for example, tension supports. If you're going to add insulators, here you can to from the list select which one insulator you want to apply, and also here possibility to applying on all tension poles. Now you can to see that all of my tension poles are with the added insulators. Okay, let's now add insulators on suspension poles. If I rotate it for better visibility, you can to see that currently my suspension supports are without insulators, but now I will add it on all of my suspension supports on my alignment. Let's select this one from the library of the power pad and press OK. Now I have added insulators also on my suspension poles. Of course, you can edit insulators by removing or changing it, but let's go farther. I want to add conductors on my alignment. Let's define to be that phase 1, select conductor model. Of course, in solution existing different types of the conductor models. Define from which to which support you want to add, and define the conditions of conductors. Let's to add another one phase, phase 2. I will attach on attachment point 2. And let's add one more phase, let's say phase 3, but I will choose another one, conductor, and press OK. How you can to see? You can immediately see it in 3D view. All of the conductors, actually all of the real position of the conductors on all alignment. Okay. You can to see the difference between the phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3, because for phase 3 I use different type of the conductor, and that is the reason why I have the bigger sag on phase 3. I can to edit conductor, for example, let's change that conductor on phase 3 with another one conductor and press OK. When you want to change conductor, it is possible by changing by tension section. Or, of course, if you want to change to the all power line, you can to remove that phase, for example, phase 3, and add again phase 3. Okay, now you can to see my alignment with the poles, insulators, and conductors. Let's go on next step. But first, for better preview, let's turn off the visibility of this raster image. Once again, to show you in 3D realistic view how it looks, I will turn on triangles of my surface. And then I will switch just visual style to realistic. Okay, now you can to see in realistic view how my alignment or power line looks. Okay, once again, I have defined alignment with the tension and suspension poles and with the insulators and conductors. Let's maybe in this tension section, in this actually first tension section, also change the type of the conductor. You need just to select which phase you want to change, and then need to change conductor model. Okay. Now I'm going in 2D view, actually in top view, to go on next step for creating profile. Let's turn on raster image, actually layer of the raster image, and let's turn off triangulation of the surface. Now I will go to create a power line profile. I need to select for which alignment I need the profile. I need to define the name of the profile. Let's put the profile 1. Let's select first and last support. I will, of course, use all the poles. In Preference tab, you need to define the scale of your profile. Also, here is one really useful command, that is offset of the terrain. I put 7 meters for bricks. Here I put the default values of that parameters. And here in additional notation, I will just turn off 2 to show with value the lowest point of the marker and n max sag of marker. Let's put the power line profile somewhere in your drawing. If I zoom on Rubric data, first what you can see here, that is Rubric station. It means station for each of the pole which we have on our alignment. Okay. Another rubric is terrain elevation. It means elevation of the pole where it's connected with the terrain. Also, rubrics are span, tangent sections that are actually length or distance between the poles and distance in each of the tangent sections. Also, we have other parameters which are, for example, conductor model. If I zoom on that graphical part, above of the each pole, I have more detail about that pole. Or also, if I zoom on the catenaries, I have the values for lowest point and maximum sag. When you zoom on terrain, you can see that we have three lines. The green one line is the line of the terrain. Orange line and blue line are offset of terrain. And we defined, or I defined it in previous step, to be 7 meter. Let's go further. Actually, later I will present you how we can to add data model for support, insulator and conductor. But let's go now on the part which is for reporting. First, before we start the reporting, let's check the weather and reference condition. In solution, you already have defined weather and reference condition, but also you can edit it or add new one. For example, if I'm going on reference condition, I can to add new one reference condition. And all of the defined weather conditions, or later defined added weather conditions, reference conditions are visible in Project Explorer. How you can to apply that conditions? It is simple, just go on your power line, edit, and here in rubric weather and reference condition, you need to choose default weather condition or your own created weather reference conditions. Let's start with reporting. The first report, which is very important for power line project, is sag tangent report. When I start command, I need to select for which power line I need to save that report. I will define for all poles and for all phases or conductors, range minus 20 until 80 degrees. At the end here, I need to define the format of that report. I will choose the Excel format. Now, just to define the name of that report, let's type sag tangent report, tangent report. Okay. And after you click Save, it will be automatically opened in Excel file. How you can to see here, for each phase of your power line, you have the parameters, of course, for the conductors and the influence of weather and reference conditions. And this is part is the most important, that are different sags and tensions for different weather conditions. Let's go on another report, that is load report. Of course, I want to create it for the all supports. And for this example, let's save it in txt file. It means plain text. Just press OK. Define the name of that report. For example, let's type loads report. And press save. After that, you will get the Report of the loads per pole. Okay, here are the main parameters, data about the pole. And after that, you have three tables, first, second, and third. And in third table are summarized load on each pole. Okay. Let's go on next report, that is quantity report. You need to select for which power line you want to take quantity report. Here I will check print for all supports because I want the quantity for all of my supports. I will save it in Excel file. Now I need just to define the name of that Excel. For example, let's type quantity report and save it. Now I can to see my quantity report and all of the quantities for supports of my power line, for insulators on my power line, and for conductors or wires of my power line. How you can to see that is very simple for reporting any of the reports. Let's go on coordination report for the power line. Here you need, of course, to select for which power line you want. There are additional settings for precision of the coordinates. And like in other reports, you need to define the type. How you will save it? I will save it in Excel file and with the name coordination report. It is very simple report for reporting XYZ coordinate of each pole of the power line. Let's go further. Before I present you how you can to import your own data models for creating power lines, it's very important to mention that PowerPad supporting imports for different types or of the software solutions, or better to say different formats. If you're going on import command, you can to see that there are more than 10 different input files which are supported with the PowerPad. For example, if someone working with Revit or SketchUp or MicroStation or any other software solution which supporting IFC or DWG or DX file, it can be imported in PowerPad. That is also very important to mention for PowerPad. Let's go farther. One of the most asked questions when users start to use PowerPad is how to add or how to import data models for supports, insulators, or conductors. First, I want to show you that you in Project Explorer under the data models have already predefined data models for supports, insulators, and cables. Let's go to present you how to can to add your data model for pole. Just select command and support data. In this dialog box, you need to define the name of your pole. For example, let's type my support. Then you need to define type, is that tension or suspension, and height of that pole. First, I want to present here system generated pole. And for example, I will add just one attachment point with Y coordinate 0.5 and Z coordinate 0.6. Okay, when I click on add, it is automatically added on list of the supports. Let's create one simple example of the power line with created support. If I rotate it in 3D view, you will see how it looks system generated 3D model of pole. It means if you don't need to have complex 3D model, you can use system generated model of support. Let's go farther. Now I wanted to open for better understanding one 3D model of the pole, which is also generated with the simple commands for 3D modeling in PowerPad. But let's to present how it looks. This is actually dimensions which I need for importing. And if I rotate this 3D model, you can to see how it looks. I will go now in previously created drawing with the system generated poles, and here I will add this real 3D model of my support. For better visibility, let's change the interface. Actually, let's change the view of the open drawing to understand which dimension I'm inserting for adding support. Let's go on add support command, define the name of the support. Let's type new pole, for example. Define the height. When you look on this photo, or actually on drawing, which I already opened, it is 9.2. I will now choose custom value, and it means that I need to find data model, or better to say geometry of the data model, which I want to insert. For plan view, I will use system generated. This also symbol can be changed. Let's go now to add attachment points. I will use the same name, attachment point 1, for left side of attachment point. And when you look here on right side in this dialog box, you can to see the schematic view of dimension which you need to insert. I add attachment point 1. Now I need to add new one attachment point. Let's say to be the dimensions which are colored in yellow. Y coordinate, Z coordinate is 1.85, and press OK. I need to add one more attachment point. This is attachment point on right side, which is colored with green. Here at Y coordinate, I need to define minus 0.545, sorry, and for Z coordinate 0.3. Let's click on add button. Okay, and let's maximize this drawing. When I now going to create one example with already created pole, you will see what I will get. This is also one simple example with the four poles. If you look in 3D, it is added actually poles which is already imported from this drawing. And like you see, it is very simple to add any of the poles. For insulators is the same way for adding. You can directly add from the ribbon, or you can go in Project Explorer and add, for example, if you want to duplicate it, it is also possible. For example, if you want to change just weight and to use the same model and say, okay, this is 10 kilograms of my new insulator. When you type the just new name, it will be automatically added in list of the insulators. Okay, when we're going on the cables, you can see that we already have predefined a library of the different cables or wires. If you want to add new one, you can duplicate existing or go on the command add new one. Okay, what is also important when you're speaking about the conductors or cables, it is that you can import and export conductor data. It means if your colleague, for example, already defined some type of the conductors, you can share it with your colleague. Let's go back on my example, where I want to present you how you can to generate beam model of your power line. I need to go on IFC export, then I need to select which power line surface I want to export. How you can to see the exporting is available in different certification of the IFC, and that is also very important because we supporting different types of certifications. I need to just type a name of that IFC format and just wait a few seconds to make that IFC record. It is automatically opening in IFC viewer. Also, it can be open any other solution with supporting IFC format. If I zooming on pole and click, all of data is shown in property set. Actually, this is metadata which are recorded in pole. If I click on insulator, for example, It's also property set for insulator, the same way is also for the conductors. And it is very important because, like you can see here, you have geometry of your power line with all elements, and all of that elements have already related data which can be used in next phases for next analysis for 4D, 5D, 6D. Okay, that is also the same when I look in any other data models. At the Power Path ribbon, you can also find the icon for settings, where you can to make a settings for units and general settings. Also, I want to mention one more time the help. If you click on help button, you will get Power Path support portal, which is actually knowledge base with the prepared material for help documentation, for video tutorials, and for learning Power Path. For example, for each of the commands which you have in Power Path, here is described with text and short video. If I'm going for tutorials for practicing and learning, I can to find here, of course, some exams which you can to use for practicing and learning Power Path. Before I finish this presentation, I wanna go back on my slides because I want to share just a few important information about the Power Path and Power Path team. Who we are and who is made the Power Path? Power Path, a new software solution for power line design, is created by Power Path company. Behind the Power Path company stand people or team who enjoy researching and developing new software solutions for architecture, engineering, construction industry. Power Path crew believe in software democratization. What it means? It means that we believe in new technologies and process like building information modeling and Internet of Things and augmented reality, because that technology can help us in process without limitation in sharing information. That is the reason why we create the Power Path software solution for power line design with open beam approach. If you want to read more about us, please visit our webpage powerpath.com. For the end, I wanted to say please check video description for more details about the Power Path. In the description of the video, you will find all of the relevant links about the Power Path. For example, some of links are about the buying solution. Please check its currently available discounted price for buying. Also, you will find link for sending request for 30 days free trial and link for free training. We had also another relevant links about the Power Path product. For the end, I want to say you big thank you for your attention. I hope this presentation was useful for you for meeting Power Path, a new software solution for power line design. Stay well and goodbye.